ago. I have been making out my templates for my curtains this morning. I'm nearly giving up the will to live because I'm not used to sewing machines. It took ages to get the machine up and running this morning. It just kept threads breaking, and I think my tension might have been a bit too strong, because it seems to be happier now that I've moved it up to two instead of one. So basically I have hemmed all around and then flipped it over on itself so that the curtain rail can go in here, and then I have a second one to go in on this end. And then I will measure it up when I get out of lockdown on a train boat, and we'll have an idea of what we're dealing with for design plans after that. I will temporarily use a stick-on version of the curtain wire with little stick-on hooks until I know this curtain design will work better or worse than having rods or whatever. And how it all looks. And then once I have a bit more experience with this machine and its capabilities and my ability to maintain a straight line in a seam, I will break out the big guns and use proper fabric. I'll also run this design past my dad because he has a lot more experience of making curtains than I have. He's recently made my sister's boat curtains. She has a motorboat up on Loch Earn, and she's replacing the originals, so at least he had a template to work off. And she now has a lovely red velvety curtains made out of old fabric that she had left over from an upholstery project that she did or had done. And then I will, as I say, run it past my dad. He might actually advise that I put on curtain tape and then have little hooky things that go onto the wire instead of having the wire going through the little pockets. But sure, we'll see. I can't go near him at the moment because we're in lockdown. Even though he just lives across the road from me, but we're level 5 lockdown in Ireland, and it means that I can't see my parents for the foreseeable future. Well, at least until the start of December, and it's now the 21st of October, and so we'll see how things pan out. But starting to get used to this beast. I was this close to just hand stitching the whole lot. I said, nah, I'm done. I'm gonna be faster doing it by hand, but I'm glad I persevered and just got through it because it's a skill to learn. And sure, I might as well learn a new skill. Might come in handy at another stage, and sure, it gives me something to do during lockdown. At least I can pretend I'm doing something towards boat improvement anyway. So as I say, new life skill been learned, and gives me something to do when it's raining outside and I can't get out to do the garden work. So yay. But anyway, so we'll see how it all pans out. As I said, 1.5 done, and another 2 sets to do, and then I'll have the 4 windows for the sides covered. I'll know better when in December when I get back up to the boat what my exact dimensions of the window covering need to be. And I'll know if I can put a few pleats in or add a little embellishment. Maybe a touch of embroidery, we'll see. What skills I can add into it. And so it's all on the go from here. Improvement, even if I do say so myself. Almost perfectly straight.